Math isn't really your strong suit, is it?
Why?
Why? That's 25 years. You know how old I'll be when you finish paying me off? Dead.
Okay, how about if I push it up to 1,100 a month?
Still dead.
When Uncle Jimmy was in the hospital, you couldn't visit because you had a cold. And your friend Barry, what's his name?
Melman, yeah.
Barry Melman was in that hospice place. You had a cold.
I did both times. I did not want to get them sicker.
You were worried you might give the guy with brain cancer a case of the sniffles?
Yes. It's called common courtesy.
Okay, fine. Whatever you need to believe.
Oh, no. What do you believe?
You're afraid.
Afraid? Oh.
I mean, it's understandable. You're getting older. You don't want to be reminded.
Reminded of what?
Really?
Yeah.
You're going to make me say it?
Come on, say it.
Dad.
Wrong. Right. That is so wrong.
I'm walking away from you.
Is standing okay?
Have you ever seen anybody sit while giving a eulogy?
I've never been to a funeral.
They stand.
Crying is a socially acceptable way to express grief. It's what you're expected to do, but people feel all sorts of things when they lose a loved one. It's just not okay to show them. So venting her anger was more interesting.
Is eating spicy food your way of thumbing your nose at the specter of death?
You wouldn't be interested in coming with me.
You're inviting me to a funeral?
My first date wound up in a hospital. Seems like a natural next step.
Hello?
Norman?
Sandy?
What are you up to this fine evening?
I'm watching Cocoon. The spaceship is taking the old people into space. That's the happy ending for old people.
If only were that easy, huh?
Yeah, I remember seeing this in the theater 30 years ago. But it's a whole different thing when you're in the demographic.
I got good news and less good news.
Okay, let's start with the less good news.
Pick again.
The good news.
The good news is you don't have to worry about cancer.
Great. Oh, that's great. Thanks, Doc. And the less good news.
We did find a couple slow-moving cancer cells in the biopsy. But you don't have to worry about it. I mean, we got to keep our eye on it, but frankly, at your age, something else in your body's going to kill you before your prostate does.
Did what just happened require any pharmaceutical help?
No. Unless you count 20 milligrams of Crestor, 10 milligrams of Claritin, 0.5 mL of Flomax, 3 grams of acetaminophen, 1 baby aspirin, and a smear of hydrocortisone cream on my left and right shin bones.
Some lists.
Oh, right. I'm not done.
Oh, shit.
I also take omega-3 fatty acids, calcium vitamins, A, C, D, E, and B12, melatonin, CoQ10, magnesium, potassium, and liquid glucosamine.
Jesus, is that it?
Yeah. Oh, also Cialis. I may not have had the career I wanted, but at least when I look in the mirror, I don't see an agent.
No, you see an old man desperately trying to look young by not shaving.
I had this look long before it was trendy. Pretty swanky, huh?
Yeah. You realize this is the first time you brought me somewhere that didn't have a dead body.
The night is still young.